Nice fish, nice fish. Good job.
Difference between fly fishing and a conventional, let's say a spinning or bait casting rod, is that we're casting the line and that's taking the fly for a ride. Whereas in spinning or bait casting, you're propelling the lure and that lure carries the line with it.
If the freshwater fly fishing opportunities we have in Florida were anywhere else in the country, it would be a huge draw for people all over the place.
Here he comes. Woo! Well, freshwater fly fishing in Central Florida has a long history. Back in the old days, over 100 years ago, winter visitors from the north would bring their fly rods down that they would use for trout, and they would dabble in the lakes for bluegill and bass. And on days like today, on some of these Central Florida lakes that have schooling bass activity, the fly rodders are coming out. I'm starting to see more and more people showing up with even flats boats on a weekend. Rather than taking a drive over to the coast, they'll come over here and spend a nice morning. More action, less hassle, and something completely different.
Oh, he's on it, he's on it. Yes!
Good fish.
It's a pretty low barrier to entry. You get a 4 or 5 weight fly rod, you get a couple poppers, and you tie them on and go catch a fish. It doesn't require any great casting ability. All you have to do is get the fly 15 feet off the end of your rod and you can catch fish.
There's a skill as much as an art in the actual delivery of the fly, but in situations like this, it's tremendously efficient because if you miss a fish, you don't have to reel your line back in. You can strip, pick it up, and then move it off to the side and put it right back on top of the fish. Beautiful cast.
Fly fishing at its core is something that, I mean, you're doing everything. When you're casting, you're responsible for bending that rod, making everything work.
Oh, nice. Good man.
With fly tying, it kind of goes to the same thing. I'm creating this fly that I am putting in front of a fish, and if I do a good enough job of creating the fly, and a good enough job of presenting the fly to the fish, and then the fish thinks the fly looks like something it might want to eat, I've basically caught a fish out of nothing. I've created the fly, I've put the fly where it needs to go, I've hooked the fish. You can make it pretty simple and buy a fly, get a rod and go catch a fish, or you can really take the time to think about it and make something new. And it's almost an art form when you get down to it. People fly fish and tie flies for all different reasons. A lot of people, probably half of our customers who fly fish regularly, eventually get into fly tying. It's just something else that they can do that's involved with the overall sport. And it allows them to be thinking about fly fishing when they can't actually go. So if it's too hot out or it's storming, there's a hurricane coming through, you can sit down and tie flies. And it's also something, a good way to relax at night. Instead of sitting down and watching a TV show, you can sit down and spend a half hour tying some flies.
With fly fishing, you get better and better and better. You start using less muscle and force and you get into the finesse side of it. And it definitely is something you can carry with you for a long time.
So there's really no stopping point. There's always something new to explore. Whether that's a new species of fish, a new place to fish, a larger fish, whether you want to get into fly tying, there's always something else to learn.
Beautiful cast.